Okay, we move on to beta method. So for beta method, when piles are driven into saturated clay, the pore water pressure in the soil around the pile increases. So the excess pore water pressure in normally consolidated clay may be 4 to 6 times the undrained cohesion. So however, within a month or so, the pressure gradually dissipates. So the unit fraction of resistance for the pile can be determined on the basis of the effective stress parameters of the clay in remolded clay. In the remolded state, where C prime is equal to zero. So at any depth, our unit frictional resistance is equal to beta sigma sub O prime. And of course, beta is equal to K tangent of phi primes R sub R, where phi primes for phi R sub prime is the drain friction angle of remolded clay. And our sigma sub O prime is the vertical effective stress. Of course, our K is the earth pressure coefficient. So for the variation of alpha with C sub U over sigma sub O prime, we have this tabulation. We have this table. So conservatively, the magnitude of K is the earth pressure coefficient at rest, or that can be equal to this equation for normally consolidated clay, and for over consolidated clay, we are given with this expression. OCR is the over consolidation ratio. So for normally consolidated clay, our unit frictional resistance is equal to this equation, and the over consolidated clay is equal to this equation. With the value of F determined, the total frictional resistance can be determined or evaluated using this equation. So our frictional skin friction is equal to the summation of F times P times delta L. So correlation with cone penetration test. So it was found out that our unit skin friction in clay with phi is equal to zero is equal to alpha prime F sub C. Our alpha prime is the frictional resistance of F sub C. And therefore, our skin friction is equal to the summation of alpha prime F sub C, P times delta L. Then we move on to the ultimate capacity of continuous flight auger pile. So for this one, we just have a description, a brief description for the continuous flight auger pile. So the discussion is based primarily on the pile load test result in the field reported by Coleman and Arismendi and the Federal Highway Administration, or FHWA. So for granular soil, based on the pile load test in Mississippi and Louisiana that was conducted by Coleman and Arismendi, he gave the value for the skin frictional resistance for sandy soil and silty soil for drain condition equal to this beta sigma sub O prime, which should be less than or equal to 200 kilonewton per meter squared. And the values for beta can be estimated as beta is equal to 2.27 Z of M raised to 0.67 for silty soil and 10.72 Z of M raised to 1.3 for sandy soil. Z sub M is the depth in meters measured from the ground surface to the middle of the given soil layer. So the value of beta is limited 0.2 to 2.5. So therefore, our skin resistance is equal to summation of F times P times delta L, where P is the pile diameter. So according to Federal Highway Administration, the unit ultimate load, point load can be given by this equation. It should be N sub 60 should be greater than 0 but less than or equal to 75, and Q sub P is equal to this value when N sub 60 is greater than 75. Of course, N sub 60 is the field penetration number, that is the average of N60 values between one pile diameter above 2 to 3 pile diameters below the pile tip. So also, our Q sub P, which is equal now to 0.375, Q sub C, where Q sub C is the average cone penetration resistance between 2 to 3 pile diameters below the pile tip. So we have here the definition. This is a figure showing to us the definition of Z of M. So for cohesive soil, our unit frictional resistance equal to alpha times C sub U, where alpha is equal to 56.2 all over C sub U. It should be greater or equal to 25, but less than or equal to 150 kilonewton per meter squared. So according to Federal Highway Administration, they recommended that the unit, that the ultimate point resistance can be equal to 0.15 of Q sub C, where Q sub C is the average cone resistance between 2 to 3 pile diameters below the pile tip. So for point bearing capacity of piles resting on rock, so basically there are instances that the pile can be driven to an underlying layer of rock. So for that, such cases, the engineer must evaluate the bearing capacity of the rock. So the ultimate unit point resistance in rock, according to Goodman, can be approximated by Q sub P is equal to Q sub U times N sub P plus 1, where N sub P is equal to tangent squared times 45 plus V prime all over 2. Our Q sub U is our unconfined compression strength of rock. Our V prime is the drain angle of friction. So for the unconfined compression strength of rock can be determined by laboratory tests on rock specimen collected during field investigation. And for our Q sub U, during the design, it can be equal to Q sub U obtained from the laboratory divided by 5. We have here a table showing to us the typical unconfined compressive strength of rock and a typical values for the angle of friction of rock. So for that one, the factor of safety is equal to 3, should not at least equal to 3. And for our allowable point bearing capacity of pile would be equal to Q sub U, the design Q sub U multiplied to N sub P plus 1 times A sub P all over F, so all over Fs. So we have here a sample problem. Refer to the pipe pile in saturated clay shown in this figure. For the pile, we are going to calculate the skin resistance Q sub S by alpha method, lambda method, and beta method. For the beta method, we're going to use phi prime sub R is equal to 30 degrees for all clay layers. And the top 10 meter of clay is normally consolidated. The bottom clay layer has an OCR equal to 2. So we have to take note the diameter of the pile is equal to 457 mm. So from the result in our previous example, you have to estimate the pile capacity. We use factor of safety equal to 4. So this is the figure showing to us the estimation of the load bearing capacity of a driven pile. So the length of the pile is 20 meters. And the diameter for this is 457 mm. We are given with saturated clay. We're given with our undrained cohesion. And of course, we have here a stress diagram showing to us the area for each layer, so that we can compute for our effective vertical stress. So for the first portion, of course, we have to take note that our perimeter would be equal to pi times the diameter of the pile, which is now equal to 1.436 meter. So from this, we can prepare our table so that we can calculate our skin friction using this equation. So we have the depth given. Of course, the change in the length on the depthness is identified. You have the undrained cohesion per layer. And of course, we are given, we have obtained our alpha from table 9.10. And now we can use this equation. We can multiply alpha times C sub U times P times delta times delta L. So we can obtain this value for the Q sub S for each depth. So therefore, our skin friction would be the summation of all of this, and that is equivalent now to 1050 kilonewton. So we can obtain the average and drain cohesion from this. We just multiply C sub U to delta L, so all over, since all over the total length, which is 20. So therefore, summing up this one, getting the average value of C sub U, we get 62.75 kilonewton per meter. So the average value of sigma sub O prime would be equal to, you get the area from the stress diagram. So the area was identified for A1, A2, and A3. Divide this all throughout by the total length. That gives us 98.85 kilonewton per meter squared. So from the table 9.9, the magnitude of lambda is equal to 0.173. So using this value, we could identify that you multiply lambda to the sigma sub O prime plus 2 times our C sub U, which we have obtained a while ago, and that gives us 38.81 kilonewton per meter squared. So therefore, our skin friction using this equation now is equivalent to 1,114.4 kilonewton. The top layer of the clay, which is 10 meters, is normally consolidated. So there, which is our phi sub r prime is 30 degrees. So therefore, from z, for z, which is equal to 0 to 3, using this equation, simply have to substitute the values. So substituting the values for phi sub r prime and our sigma sub o prime, this sigma sub o prime is taken from this table, from this stress diagram. So from 0 to 3, that is 48. From 0 to 10, that is 98.33. And from 0 to 20, our sigma sub O prime is 180.23. So therefore, if you try to substitute that one, that would be 0 plus 48 all over 2. So 6 point, multiply all the out with this, that is 6.93 kilonewton per meter squared. When Z is 3 to 10 meters, substitute the value for this one. So we have here 3 to 10, so that is 48 plus 98.33 over 2, so gives us 21.12 kilonewton per meter squared. For Z equal to 10 to 20, so our sigma sub O prime would be equivalent to 98.33 plus 180.23 all over 2, multiply that to our OCR, which is 2, your phi sub r prime. So multiply all throughout, you have 56.86 kilonewton per meter squared. So therefore, our skin friction, Q sub s, you simply have to sum up perimeter. So that is 5 times the diameter of the pile. Then multiply to the summation of our skin friction for each layer, it gives us 1058.45 kilonewton. So our ultimate bearing capacity would be point bearing capacity plus skin friction. From our previous example, our Q sub P is 151 kilonewton. So therefore, we take our the value for Q sub S, since the value for Q sub S for the different method, lambda, beta, and alpha are very close. So we get the average to this. So that is 1074 kilonewton. So when you add this one to 151 kilonewton, divide to our factor of safety, which is 4, our allowable load bearing capacity for the pile is 306.25 kilonewton, or approximately 306 kilonewton. Then we move on to pile load test. So we have here a figure showing to us a load settlement diagram from the field loading and underloading. And for any load Q, the net pile settlement can be calculated using this equation. So the load settlement diagram from the field loading and unloading is illustrated on this. Here we have here an schematic diagram. This one is the schematic diagram for the load pile test arrangement. And this one is the plot of load against total settlement. So our net settlement actually, net settlement is equal to total settlement of this minus this settlement S of E. So this one, let figure C showing us a plot of load against net settlement. So our Q, which is equal to Q sub 2. So when Q is equal to Q sub 2, the net settlement therefore is equal to this total settlement for this. This total settlement minus this S of E. So this is for Q is equal to Q sub 2. A while ago, we have Q is equal to Q sub 1. The net settlement is equal to total settlement, this one minus this S of E. So our S net, S of net is the net settlement. S of E is the elastic settlement of the pile itself. And S of T is the total settlement. So this one is a Davidson method for the determination of the ultimate load.